You are listening to the Zion Experience. Listen with discretion. It's not for your mother.
Yo, Iggy Pop and the Stooges, Search and Destroy. It's another vinyl experience on November, whatever the fuck day it is, 20, whatever, 13, and sitting here in studio with Mr. Old Greg.
How the fuck do you not know what day it is?
I just don't, man.
Seriously.
I that doesn't matter. It doesn't pertain to me in my lifetime.
Yeah.
You know?
Uh-huh. Just another fucking day,
that.
Right?
Just another fucking day.
Another fucking day in
well,
paradise.
Well, I can tell you what day it is like Tuesday. Is it Tuesday? Am I correct?
Yeah.
Tuesday. Cool. Yeah. Cool. And Mr. Palsy sitting over here.
He's 26.
26th, he says.
And that's ex-palsy to you.
That's right. Oh. Ex-palsy to you, buddy.
That's right. He has, he's come a long ways since last week. Last week.
Are he, looking good.
He looked pretty strokey.
Yeah.
Kind of strokey.
Dude, dick.
Is that a dick move?
That was a dick move, man.
I'm not strokey. Seriously. I'm not on the couch.
Oh, there you go. Oh, that kind of strokey. So right. Anyways.
We're cleaning this up. Right?
Anyway,
yeah, that's right. Yeah.
What'd you do to move it along? Because last you told me is like 6 months before you even noticed anything.
Yeah. What's
I've
up with that?
Noticed a lot.
Well, yeah, I.
He's been working
mind games with myself, really.
Yeah?
He's been working it, man.
I just tricked myself into thinking it'd work, and it worked.
And it did the trick, huh?
You bet.
Huh. No shit.
Face yep. moves, man. Face moves.
Face
doctor
moves.
Pretty
face
much moves. Sent me home and told me he couldn't do anything for me. Keep whatever doing. The hell I'm doing, keep doing it.
No shit.
Yep.
No shit. So I had some complaints last show that from the last show that the show was a little too naughty. Is that right? Greg, did you think it was too naughty?
Dude, I told you before. Some of the content was good.
Yeah.
All right. You got a little too hot and heavy on the hooker thing. Yeah, like, you got a little too hot and heavy on the freaking audio erotica thing.
Well, I get into that kind of stuff and I get excited, man.
Well, okay, I understand. That's kind of what creeped me out. All right?
That's part of the creep out.
Yeah, huh? That was probably what creeped everybody else out. Hey, everybody, I'm sorry that Dustin has a problem. All right?
And it's not it's not really excited. It's like I get into well, I guess it's excited either way. But I get into a flow of things, and then I just can't quit. It's kind of – I don't know what
it happens.
Call
it happens. Like I said, what we should have done is, you know, a little more context on the things. There were topics – yeah, cocktails. There you go. But, no, there were topics that could have been talked about there. Things that like I said, boggle me still.
Right.
Like the audio erotica. Right. I don't get how guys – can enjoy that kind of thing and listen.
Why not?
Because it's
okay,
just listening.
Let me lay this one on you. Say you're a truck driver, and to be on the safe side, you wanted to, you know, you're in the mood, and to be on the safe side and still make time, you pop in some audio erotica instead of trying to watch porn on your phone while you're driving.
Dude, are you serious?
Yeah.
They make all these little clippy things. You could put that shit right up by the fucking window, watch porn and the road all at the same time.
Yeah, I'm too scared to watch anything and then try to drive too.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah,
I'd do it.
I'd fucking wreck.
I fucking do it.
Yeah, you'll
if
fucking
I
wreck.
Can fucking do it, then a goddamn truck driver can do it. That's what he does for a fucking living is drive. All right? He should be an expert at driving and watching porn.
Especially if you're a dirty old truck
yeah,
driver.
Yeah, especially if you're a dirty old truck driver. Besides, man, they got fucking brakes and all that shit. They can take breaks and watch their porn.
That's true.
The thing is it's just a little weird.
I don't know. You told me how many times did you masturbate?
Dude,
two or three times
a
day?
No, like four or five times a day.
How's a truck driver supposed to meet quota and still masturbate four or five times a day?
Dude, he's on the road for hours. Dude, you kidding me?
Yeah.
I was a truck driver and
yeah.
I was on the road for 10 hours.
Yeah.
That means I masturbate 10 times a day.
Because oh,
I would,
that
masturbate
means you would masturbate
every fucking
more
hour.
Often?
Yeah.
So Palsy, did you think the show was too naughty last week?
I don't see a problem with, you know, just cutting loose every once in a while.
Yeah. Well, that was definitely cutting loose from because I've never once I've talked about some really nasty shit.
Well,
over
we did,
these, over
you know,
these podcasts.
We
never
had a lot
once
of,
have I had a complaint.
We had fun and.
Yeah, and that's what it's all about.
Yeah, I
it's,
mean, you
it's
know,
about
we got serious
entertaining.
Topics and stuff all the time. But
yeah.
You get a fun one once in a while. What's,
right.
I don't see a problem.
This podcast is to entertain the listeners, you know?
Right, but
and
again.
It's not necessarily my views or old Greg's views or Palsy's views or whoever else is in the you know, on the show. It's just the sole purpose is to entertain. Nothing else. You know what I mean?
But if somebody doesn't like what you like for entertainment,
yeah,
then we
could,
got a problem.
It could
See,
be.
That's what I'm
be
saying.
People that don't. Run.
Well, I understand.
No matter what you what
like.
You talk
here's
about
the thing, or, though. I got nothing wrong with porn. I got nothing wrong with talking about masturbation. I got nothing wrong with any of that stuff.
Yeah.
But like I said last week, I think we kind of pushed a little too far. That's
yeah.
All.
We and we
a little
might
too
have.
Far.
I thought maybe we did too.
I think a little bit. But you know what? If we did. Fuck y'all.
Well, I think what happened is I put too much erotica into one show instead
yeah,
of trying
was,
to like put it into split it up and put
yeah.
it a little bit here and a
right.
little bit next show. A little
it was
bit
like
next
it
show.
Was like super kink section.
Yeah,
last
it was
week.
Just
it was a little too much.
It probably
like I said
was.
I don't mind what we did. And
I
like
don't
I said,
either.
If anybody else minds, then fuck off. But you know,
we had a themed show.
Yeah,
it definitely
it was
a themed show.
Yeah, it was themed. You are right about that, Palsy.
You're right.
I'm sorry, ex-Palsy.
I don't know. The only thing I thought was, you know, we kind of drug it out at the end. But I agree. It was enjoyable.
I thought it was, overall,
when I listened to it again, I mean.
It wasn't that bad. But
overall, like I thought it was pretty humorous.
Honestly, I have a buddy in Kansas City that I got to listen to that show, and he was really not into that kind of talking at all or anything. And
he loved
it. He's one of your followers now.
Yeah. Oh, he loved it.
He thought it was humorous.
And that's the thing. Yeah. You don't really know. So like I said,
you're going to step on toes.
If we offended anybody, fuck the hell off, man. All right? It happens. Okay? Right. We were a little drunk. We were calling hookers. So the fuck what?
Right. And then sometimes it'll go to
excessive points. Sometimes it does.
It does.
That's
how it works.
We excessively talk about masturbation, and that's right. never going to stop. So
well,
fuck off.
We're men.
Yeah?
We are not mice. So
he's a mice.
Yeah. But we went to the new bar this weekend. I think I finally figured out the name of it. It's Eldo Sports Bar. Period.
Yeah, that's period. It. Just Eldo Sports Bar.
Eldo
like
Sports
period
Bar
at the end. That's kind of
well.
They should put
don't
period
let it
off a little bit.
Don't let
no,
it
they
drive
should
you
put
away.
A period right at the end.
Don't let it drive you away. It's
they should period. That's what it is. That's it. Period.
The inside, super nice, man. The whole bar is super
nice.
Dude,
it was. It was pretty nice, actually. I was impressed as far as how they kind of
remodeled
it.
They have a pool table room.
Yeah. And four pool tables.
That's really nice. It has
plenty of room.
Fucking dead animal mounts all over the place.
You can get up close and personal with that moose, man.
Yeah.
You can French kiss a moose if you want to.
That's not a moose, Greg. That's actually a caribou.
The caribou. Okay, you're right. No, yeah. You're right. My bad.
But I thought it was pretty good. The prices, some things were a little steep, but some things were cheap. I mean,
hey, all I gotta say is don't get the small beer. Get the big one because it's only $1 more.
Get the great big beer for $5,
right.
Or you could get like
a pint.
I think it's just a little over a pint.
Yeah,
for four.
Yeah. So you might as well get the big bastard.
Yeah, yeah. $5. I mean, I go down to sometimes I go down to Four Winds on Thursday nights because they have dollar beers.
Dollar beers, man. I gotta go to this.
And it's just a pint of beer for a dollar, and it's mainline.
But it's a buck.
Yeah, it's a buck. But honestly, I think you could pour 5 of those pints into that one glass that you got.
Yeah,
if not, pretty close. I mean, it's still that's their everyday sale, man. That's not on special.
It's not
or
on special or thing or anything.
Right.
And it's any draft beer that they have on tap, which is great. That's why I drink Blue Moon.
Right, they got Blue Moon. They got some good beers on tap.
They do.
I tell you what.
Tip them good. Cause
and
if you tip them good, they'll let you play bowling.
Yeah, they have.
They'll let you bowl for free.
They got bowling there, and bowling's a lot of fun when you get all tanked up.
Oh hell yeah, it is. Hell yeah, it is.
My band actually got invited to play New Year's show.
Oh yeah,
yeah, yeah, at that bar. So it should be pretty fun.
Which band is that? Just messing with
you. I only have one band. But anyways, let's spin the record.
Oh,
Light, white heat. Have you guys seen It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah? That is probably my... No, that is my favorite sitcom of all time. All time.
Better than Family Guy.
In my opinion. I know that's not everybody's opinion, but that's my opinion.
Yeah.
I really love that fucking show.
I'll give you that.
So, I think it was season 7. They went to New Jersey and go to the Jersey Shore.
Uh-huh.
I think that was the right one. I could be mistaken. But anyways, they poured wine into like a beer can. And they would walk around all the time, all over the place, drinking wine out of the can. So guess what?
What?
Somebody has actually copied them. And it's wine in a can. Coming to a store near you. It's by Friends.
What?
Yeah. That's the name of the company or vineyard or whatever the fuck they call it.
What?
Friends.
So.
Wine in a can.
It's a fucking wine beer.
No.
Well, you know what I'm saying?
It's just wine.
It's wine in a can.
Yeah. Bottom. This article says, for those of us who have always wanted to shotgun a glass of Merlot.
Oh, my God. Wow.
Here you go.
Why the fuck would you want to... Wow.
Yeah.
Why would you want to shotgun Merlot?
Hey, don't judge. Don't judge.
No. Give me a wise Zen, maybe.
Right.
A Merlot?
But it's... Whoa. It comes in a 250 milliliter aluminum can.
250 milliliter.
Yep. It's... sold by Friends Wine in
that's
a can.
Not even, that's not even a fuck. That's not even like a regular beer.
No, it's a little over a half pint. But that's probably a big glass of wine.
That's freaking gay.
Yeah.
If you're going to do it, make it the same size as a freaking beer.
Right. So they actually are going to offer two varieties of canned French vino. It's going to be a white Moscato and a strawberry Moscato. And they partnered up with Spirit Airlines, and they're going to be priced at $7 a can, I believe.
On their flight.
Yep, to travelers flying on the discount carrier. It says, feel free not to pour it in a glass.
Shit, they already made little mini bottles. I mean, what the heck?
Yeah. Well, now you can get it in a can.
In a can.
Shit,
wine
yeah.
in a can.
Shit, yeah.
See, I'm a firm believer that, you know, beer tastes better out of a bottle. I would think that wine would taste better out of the bottle.
Yeah.
Wouldn't you think that the aluminum or something in the cans would
kind
of make the wine?
Yeah, I would imagine.
Weird?
I would imagine.
I mean, have you ever had, like, grape juice out of a can?
Yeah, it tastes a little,
weird.
Metally.
Yeah.
Is that a word? Metally?
No, totally, because, maybe it's the acids or something in the grapes, but I would think that wine would taste weird out of a can.
I do, too. Do you?
Boxed wine tastes weird.
I like
soda
wine.
And everything else tastes different too out of a can.
Yeah,
way different.
Do you like wine, Palsy?
Oh,
not
it's
like
all
on
right,
a
I guess.
On occasion, or if somebody has some, you might drink some.
Yeah, I've had a few good ones.
Yeah, I get it. I get
you gotta
it.
Have a good glass of wine with your dinner or something like that.
I suppose so. What about you? You didn't like boxed wine, old Greg?
Not big on it.
I don't mind it.
If I could throw tastes that, flat or something. No.
I throw that shit in the fridge and fucking pour it by the glass.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I don't know, man. Something about it. It's just kind of weird.
Yeah,
It is a little weird for me. Like I said, it's almost like it's, like I said, flat, I guess, is the best way to.
Yeah.
You know how you get a beer that's warm and doesn't taste right? Been opened for too long or something.
Yeah,
you know?
I get it.
That's how boxed wine is for me.
Oh, just tastes kind of staley. Huh?
Yeah, I mean, if you don't pop the cork on that wine and get that fresh glass, man, it just don't. It's not the same.
Yeah, I get it. What about bottled wine, but it has a cap on it?
The capped ones?
Yeah, do they bother you?
Yeah, not as much, no.
Yeah.
No. I mean, it's still sealed up like that, so it's a little different.
Touché.
Yeah.
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 So, do you know anything about sociopaths?
I don't know. I probably know a whole bunch of them.
Well, you might. Because did you know that 1 in 20 people are sociopaths?
Really?
Yeah. For those of you that don't know, the definition of a sociopath is somebody is born without a conscience. Could you imagine that?
I'm a sociopath.
No, you're not.
Oh, I have no conscience, man.
Yes, you do.
Have you heard the shit that I say on this show? Do you really think I have a conscience?
All right. You run over a dog, you feel bad.
No.
No? You run over.
Is it my dog?
Yeah.
No.
You run over a dog and kill it, and you don't fucking care?
Dumbass dog shouldn't have been under me in my car.
Yeah. Well, maybe you are a sociopath. Look at this. It says, here's some ways to figure out if somebody's a sociopath or not.
Okay.
Glibness and superficial charm.
Uh-huh.
That might be old Greg right there.
Yeah. Okay, keep going.
Manipulative and conning.
Oh, shit. Ding, 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 ding.
Grandiose sense of self.
Oh, ding.
Yeah.
Have I told you how perfect I am?
Yeah.
Okay. Ding.
And, pathological lying. I don't know.
I have to say X on that one, man. Yeah. I don't really lie. I mean, I'm pretty honest. But.
Right. Lack of remorse, shame, or guilt.
Ding. Ding.
Shallow emotions.
Shallow emotions?
Yeah.
Like, what do you mean by shallow emotions?
It's like joy, warmth, joy, love, compassion.
I mean, how many of these do you have to get right to be a sociopath?
I hope all of them, man.
I hope so, too, because I'm doing okay. I'm not a sociopath yet. I'm borderline. How about that?
There you go.
Yeah.
Shallow emotions?
Yeah.
Incapacity of love?
No, see, that's not really true for me.
Callousness or lack of empathy?
Yeah, ding, ding.
This is you right here. Poor behavioral controls, impulsive in nature. Because I went to garden with you today, and I had to fucking hold you off of fucking beating up the tape player.
Dude,
I had to hold you back.
Dude, the motherfucking thing wouldn't work. Pissing me off, man. You don't keep flipping sides on me, okay? Not when a good song is on.
So anyways, my point being is...
I'm borderline sociopath?
Well, not you. I always wondered about you.
Yeah, well, there you go. Now
actually,
you know.
To me, sociopath's probably even more dangerous than a psychopath.
You think?
Yeah.
Nah.
Oh, I do.
No.
Because you know how hard it is to find out if somebody's a sociopath or not before they get one over on you?
Yeah, but they're not doing anything super dangerous. Psychopath does fucked up things.
Yeah, look at Congress.
Oh, dude, fuck that. You know, I'm sorry. Congress, yeah.
To me, Congress, I think, is full of them.
You know what, though? That's our own goddamn fault for letting it happen, okay? So we're all fucking sociopaths in that regards, okay?
No, I mean, there's just not enough people that are going to stand up and go against a government. And they know it. You know what I mean?
No, see, I disagree. I think there's plenty of people out there that would. Just nobody's got the fucking balls to actually do it. You know,
well, yeah.
Everybody wants to.
Right.
But who's going to, you know, grow some fucking balls, people? Let's do this.
They're all worried about the repercussions.
Nah. That's why I don't get involved. Fuck all that.
Right.
I don't give a fuck. I don't give a fuck about the president. I don't give a fuck about Congress. Let them do what they fucking want to do. Because you know what? In the end, They still can't control me.
Yeah.
So fuck them.
Let me lay this one on you.
All right.
When you went to school as a kid, who do you think delegated what you learned and how you learned it?
Me?
No.
Bullshit.
No. Who taught you?
Teachers tried.
Teachers.
They tried.
Teachers taught you.
They tried.
Okay. You know who's the boss of the teachers?
I don't give a fuck.
Just answer the question.
The principal. Government?
The principal.
Okay.
Who's the boss of the principal?
The superintendent.
Who's the boss of the superintendent?
Fucking state.
Administration.
Whatever.
State.
Uh-huh.
Who's the boss of the state?
The government.
Yeah. The federal government tells, and it's going on right now.
Well, sure it is.
It's gone
dude.
On for since people started going to school.
I'm a firm believer, though, in that you still have the choice to believe in what you want to believe in.
Right.
Learn what you want to learn. So fuck that. That's why I say, who taught me or what did I, you know, who delegated what I learned in school?
Right.
Me.
Who taught you how to count?
Me.
No, somebody taught you how to
bullshit.
Count. You didn't know.
Me.
You just figured it all out.
Well, no.
Okay. Then.
But I decided.
Right.
That was correct.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, have you decided? Okay, let me lay this one on you. Okay, does this Earth revolve around the Sun, or does the Sun evolve around the Earth?
Well, I don't know. I'm not a fucking scientist.
No, you should know because they taught you this in school.
Well, the Earth revolves around the Sun.
That's incorrect.
No.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
No,
that's the planets. That's all the planets
see,
move
see,
in
listen,
an orbit around the Sun.
That's incorrect. You know how I don't. It could be correct, but I don't know. There is no answer to that question.
What?
No, nobody knows.
Why the fuck did they tell us that then?
Exactly my point, man. That's why they fucking tell you that.
Hey, you
it's
know what, though?
The
why the fuck is Pluto not a goddamn planet anymore?
Because they quit teaching it in schools, man.
Yeah,
and that's what they
bullshit.
Want you to know. They probably found life on Pluto, and that's why.
Right? Like, right. It ain't a planet. A bunch
right?
of fucked up motherfucking aliens up in there.
That's what I'm saying. That's kind of my point, man. Is
no, I get you. I mean, I understand that they're regulating things, and they're trying to make us believe what they want us to believe or whatever.
Not just things. Everything. Everything that you do, the government regulates it. Yeah, that from that beer you're drinking to, you know, the tools you use to make a living. Everything is regulated by the government or ran by the government.
I make my own tools.
Well, not everybody is. And no, those materials you use to make those tools.
Oh, I know. It's all government regulated, right. And I understand all that.
Did you know it's illegal to collect rainwater now?
Dude, fuck them.
You know why?
Because it's free?
Yeah, because exactly. It's because they can't fucking tax it.
Yeah.
So anyway,
why do you think they're so against all these gardens and shit going up and all these things that people are doing to be self-sufficient, you know?
That's, you know, yeah, exactly. They don't want you to do that.
But at the same time, they'll still promote certain aspects of self-sufficiency.
It's called brainwashing.
Oh, yeah. They want you to believe that you're free still.
Yeah, it's
well,
called brainwashing.
Yeah. That's why I'm a firm believer, and if you want to be free, be free.
Yeah.
Believe what you want to believe. Do what you want to do. And you know what? If they fucking lock you up for it, tell them to fuck off.
Right.
Because that's the only way you can live free. Stop giving a shit.
Yeah,
you know?
I hear you.
You can't sit here and let the government decide what you're going to fucking do or who you're going to be. You just can't do it.
You can't, but
that's what they want to do.
Well,
of course that's what they want to do. Dustin, they've been doing that for way too fucking long.
Exactly. That's another point of mine. It's like, you know, when does society or humanity say enough is enough?
Well, we won't, ever.
Why?
Because we decided to fucking let it happen.
Yeah, and now we're almost at the point of no return, man.
Well, yeah.
I mean, well, we could, but we just don't have the guts to anymore, to be honest.
No.
Yeah. We're a bunch of chicken shits.
Yeah.
We really are.
No, we've actually...
Why do you think these other countries fucking have riots and uprisings
and
bullshit?
We've been domesticated here.
Yeah. Yeah, we've been turned to sheep.
Yeah, we really have.
Basically.
Yeah, I mean, there's a few, but, you know, those few got to get everybody else fired up, and
yeah.
I don't think anybody else just has the motivation.
I don't think it's the motivation. I think, like I said earlier, I think it's the in fear of the repercussions.
Nah, fuck that. Do not live your ass in fear, period.
Yeah, I think that's
do
how it
not
is,
live
so.
In fear. You know what, government? If you hear me now, fuck off. I'm free. You can't control me. I don't give a fuck.
That fucking satellite's going to come down. And
I don't give a fuck. Bring it.
Anal reprogram.
Bring it. Bring the goddamn Secret Service up in here. I don't give a shit. Take me down.
Yeah.
Because it's going to take fucking six of you motherfuckers.
Right. So another thing that the government's trying to tell you what to do and try to control you is this Obamacare stuff.
Oh, I've heard a little about this.
Right. Well, you don't have insurance, do you?
Me?
Yeah.
Nope.
I don't have insurance either. Jerome?
Yep.
You have insurance through employment, right?
Yep.
Now, are they going to try to cut your hours?
No.
No? That's
good. I know that's happening.
Yeah, a lot of businesses have cut people's hours because they couldn't afford or didn't want to afford the Obamacare health insurance.
My employment is through the state, who's
right.
Not
exempt, basically.
Well, they're not at – there's not really anybody putting forward the risk to have to pay that for the employees, you know what
right.
I mean? Because the people of the state are, so.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I mean, when it's your own business and your own company, then all the risk on investing in that is on you.
Right.
And
right.
And it could kill you. So,
yeah.
I mean,
yeah,
business-wise.
You may not have anything to go to work in the morning or
right.
anything like that. So I've looked it up. For people like Greg and I who don't have insurance, throw me a number out there, Greg, that what you think it's going to cost.
For what?
For health insurance.
For me to have health insurance?
Through the health.gov or whatever the fuck it's called.
Oh, for me?
Yeah.
Oh, man, I'm sure that would cost me a shit ton.
Just throw a number out there.
Probably.
Per month.
Per month, I'm going to say probably about $1,200 per month.
No, you're way off. But it's no, it's $350 a month. Every month, guess what your deductible would be?
What?
$6,000.
That's the way they did
it. Oh, okay.
So you can afford it.
Dude, I can't afford
no $350
fucking a month.
The price is low.
You know how much insurance?
But they make it up in deductible.
No, because insurance would have cost me.
I can't
me.
Afford $350
yeah, a month. Insurance, yeah. When I did have carry insurance for my self-employment,
yeah,
it cost me $100 a month.
Right.
That's it.
Right.
And that was with a $500, or no, I'm sorry, a $1,000 deductible.
Yeah.
Right. But it covered everything.
Right.
And I mean everything.
Yeah, this covered.
My prescriptions. Yeah. My visits, and we're not talking just, you know, a cheap-ass, like, 30% coverage thing. No, this was, like, 70, 80% coverage.
Oh, yeah.
But how long right? ago was this?
Well, I mean, it's been a while back,
yeah.
But still.
I mean, it's
know.
Not that ballgame anymore.
Well.
Especially since this came out.
But,
right.
you know.
Because everybody else has had to go up.
My whole thing, though, is that you're taking away the competitiveness of any company
yeah.
here.
No. What's happening is somebody's getting really fucking rich off of this.
Yeah, the government.
Somebody's getting really fucking rich.
Of course, the government
because
is.
Because this $6,000 deductible is basically means that I don't have any insurance until I pay $6,000.
Yeah.
That's the basic, you know.
Well, yeah, you're paying $350 a month.
Right.
Right. But you have a $6,000 deductible.
Yeah. Yeah.
So your $350 a month means jack fucking shit.
Yeah, it doesn't mean shit
yeah.
until you meet the fucking $6,000.
Right, until you get to $6,000.
Right.
Ah, no, fuck all
yeah,
that.
Yeah, that's fucked up. You know what else is fucked up? You know, they've had the problems with that health.gov internet site and stuff
yeah,
like that?
Yeah, I've been hearing about that.
Okay. Do you know that they subcontracted it out to a company in Canada?
So our
and it cost
healthcare.
Us. It cost. Guess how much it cost to build this website?
What?
$7 trillion.
To build a website.
Yes.
Right.
Something
yes.
that one guy can sit at his home and do.
Yeah.
Hey, government.
$7 trillion.
I'm a website designer.
$7 trillion. No.
Can I get $7 trillion?
Your trouble is that you live in America.
Oh. Oh.
So
I'll move to fucking Canada if that's what it takes.
No,
give me $7 trillion, I'll move to fucking goddamn Zimbabwe, all right?
To me, this is a good way to launder money.
I don't know.
You know what I mean? Because if you had illegal money, you wouldn't hire a company in the United States and pay them $7 trillion to build a website that probably would have cost, you know, maybe $1 million at the most.
Right.
Why would it even cost $1 million?
Well, dude, I have no idea. I don't build
You can get on there right now, build you a goddamn website,
yeah,
it could cost you nothing.
A shitty one.
Well, this one's fucking great because apparently nobody can get on there and do what they got to do.
Well, I don't know, dude. You got a point there.
Yeah, right?
The thing with the kind of website they're building, though, is you got to have a pretty good database. And
right.
When you get into that kind of stuff, then... But the thing is, they spent that much money...
Somewhere
also,
else.
I was hearing this. They yeah. spent that much money building a website with post-dated technology... That the same website could have been built for $1 million with, current technology.
Hey, here's an idea. How about we take $7 trillion and
put it
towards our budget or our deficit instead of towards a website?
Right.
How about we take $7 trillion and pay our fucking military what they need to get paid?
And then it didn't work.
You know?
Yeah, and then the internet site hasn't worked.
Yeah. Well, yeah.
So.
There's $7 trillion.
Yeah, that's no
lie. Do you realize what $7 trillion could do for this country other than a fucking website that doesn't work?
Well, it could keep China from bombing us.
Well, yeah.
Or taking an ass-whooping out on us.
You take fucking $7 trillion and you fucking pay off all those fucking banks that went down under. You know?
Right.
You take $7 trillion, you pay off our fucking...
No, think about it.
That's a goddamn federal deficit.
Let me lay this one on you. What's the population of the United States?
The population?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
What is it like?
Wow, it's got to be...
Like 5 million, 6 million, 7 million?
Oh, more than that.
No. It's like 600
it's,
or something.
Yeah, it's more
600
than that.
Million?
It's got to be up there,
okay,
man.
Okay, get this. 600 million people in the United States or something like that. Even if there was, you know, let's say 1 billion.
Yeah.
You could give everybody... in the whole United States, a fucking shitload of money. Like, I'm talking millions here.
That's what I'm talking about.
$2 or $3 million a piece.
Yeah.
And say, you can't spend that on anything except for healthcare.
Yeah.
Problem solved.
$7 trillion.
Yeah.
There are so many other ways you could use $7 trillion.
Well, that's the thing, man, is if somebody didn't want to get super rich... They could have gave that $7 trillion or, you know, didn't have a hidden agenda. They could have gave that $7 trillion.
I'll agree with you there. Something's fucked up there.
To the U.S.
Yeah, something's fucked up because I agree with you there. Instead of spending $7 trillion on a website, you take that and you give $1 million. give everybody in the world $1 million. Just give it to them.
Say that's nothing but for healthcare.
Don't even tell them what it's for. Just give them $1 million. If everybody was a millionaire, shit.
Well, smart people would have lasted it. The people like that are on the welfare and stuff like that.
They wouldn't be on welfare anymore, would they? You're a fucking millionaire.
They probably would be in a year.
You don't qualify anymore.
That's what I'm saying is they probably would be in a year. Just like Jerome said. Or,
yeah. You're probably right.
That's what I'm saying. Let's spin a record. How was that?
That's a good one.
How was that?
I like it.
You did?
Yeah.
Palsy?
Yeah, it was all right.
It was all right?
All right.
I thought it was all right.
All right. That's just the palsy talking.
No, the palsy stuff is when he becomes witty.
Oh, yeah. So he is ex-palsy then.
All right. Greg, you got kids.
Oh, yeah.
Do they have Facebook?
Oh, no.
No, not yet?
Not yet.
Not yet. They're a little young yet.
Yeah.
I have a kid.
It doesn't seem to matter to some people.
I sure hope yours doesn't have a Facebook page.
No, she's way too young for that. Way too young for that. But anyways, there are parents that do have kids.
Right.
You know?
Yeah.
Like they do.
There's seriously, there's parents that have kids?
Parents that
Holy
don't
shit,
have kids.
Dustin.
I know. Can you believe it?
Wow.
And some of these people use Facebook as a form of punishment.
What?
Yeah.
Okay, come again?
Just for, like, every day being...
The hell does that say?
Or... Well...
What?
Like, what they do is they post humiliating photos of themselves, like the parents being goofy or whatever. Mm-hmm. Something that would get you beat up in school, I'm sure.
Yeah.
You know? And so, anyways, they post these humiliating photos to punish their kids on Facebook.
You're kidding me.
No, dude. Like an old ass whooping wouldn't fucking do the trick anymore.
Yeah, well.
Why in the hell?
Right?
Why?
I don't have any idea, dude.
No.
Okay, you have a daughter that's probably getting really close to having
Facebook. She's getting close.
Real close to having Facebook.
Yeah.
And would you ever even, I mean, I would understand taking Facebook away.
Well, yeah. I would definitely take it away or punish her in some other way before publicly humiliating her.
Right? Yeah, I just think that's immorally wrong and fucked up.
Well, sure. I'm not going to post anything about my kids unless it's something good, man. I mean,
right.
You know, I'm not going to get on there and be like, oh, yeah, my daughter was a complete retard today. Fuck that.
Are the parents taking pictures of themselves or their kids?
Both. This, like, this lady.
What is this?
What this lady did was, her name is Rashonda Tate Billingsley.
Well, there's her fucking problem.
I can't even say her name. Huh. But, she posted a photo because this, certain girl was posting photos of herself holding, like, beer and stuff like that.
Uh-huh.
And she was underage.
What does that say?
And she made this girl hold a sign up that says, "Since I want to post photos of me holding liquor on Facebook, I am obviously not ready for social media and will be taking a hiatus until I learn what I should post and should not post."
That's not that bad.
No.
That's not really that bad. I mean, that's just basically she made her daughter post that so that all her friends know that now her Facebook is gone.
Well, right. But couldn't she just say, "Hey, no more Facebook for you," and that's it? And then, I mean, word would get around to her friends, like, through school and shit like that, that maybe that she doesn't have Facebook. She's grounded from Facebook.
Yeah, but in today's society, that's the quickest way to do it. You want to post, and like, this one's not bad. Now, you know, you're talking about humiliating things, you know, or degrading things. That's one thing. When, if I caught my daughter posting pictures on Facebook, you know, of her, holding liquor and doing stupid things, I would probably say, okay, yeah, you want to post those kind of pictures? Let's post one to all your friends saying, hey, look, I'm a dumbass and I'm not going to be on Facebook anymore.
Right.
I mean, that's not that bad.
No, but it has gotten real bad.
You know, I don't have kids, so I got a different perspective.
Okay, yeah. Lay it on us.
But, you know, we're in a world where you can't bring the Switch anymore, right?
Yeah, yeah.
And I grew up with it. The Switch and the belt and the ruler and the baseball bat and the whole bit.
Right.
And, you know, it had its effect. And I don't see today, you know, you can't hardly do that. So what are you supposed to do? I mean, the whole timeout thing to me is a joke.
Yeah, I agree.
You know, I got sent to the corner sometimes too, which is basically timeout. Go sit in the corner.
Yeah.
You know, and I'd take a little rubber ball with me and bounce it around and have fun the whole time.
Sure, I mean
that never bothered me. Go to your room, you know.
No.
Oh, cool. That's where all my toys and shit are.
Yeah. You
know? No, but when your dad said, Go get a switch off of a tree.
It made its point.
And you trembled in your shoes.
Right. And you knew it.
Right.
And, you know, you take that away now because you can't because, you know, you paddle somebody and next thing you know,
you're going to jail.
Yeah. Right.
Especially if you do it in public.
Yeah.
Right. As far as I'm concerned, Facebook is public.
And you know, we're in a world now where even if a kid goes and says, this or that happened or whatever, they got to start checking it out and you're in a mess.
Yeah.
And whether you did it or not. So, you know, there's probably some parents out there coming out trying to be creative with punishments that actually have consequences
to
the kid. And they need consequences. I mean, you know, I work at the school.
Yeah.
And I see how a lot of those kids are. And it's clear that a lot of them don't have
consequences
that mean anything to them, really.
Right.
When they get in trouble, because it has no effect whatsoever.
Right.
So what are you supposed to do? You see the same thing with the teachers and stuff.
Right.
But, like, right now it's rife in the school.
It's what?
Rife.
Rife?
Yeah.
What's that?
Plentiful, I guess.
Oh, okay, okay. Sorry, I'm not hip to the...
It's like...
He's not a linguist.
No.
To have... The kids being tardy and not doing their homework and stuff in the school right now is ridiculous.
Right,
right.
I mean, honestly, it is. I won't go into details, but I see it every day. And you should see how many kids there are that have to stay after school every day. You just almost have a school after school.
Right,
right.
All the kids that have to stay after school because they're late to class or whatever.
And this is supposed to be like a detention?
Right.
Yeah.
And even in detention during the day.
Yeah.
And they don't care at
no.
all. The
no,
kids
it's
don't. Good.
No.
You know, they're...
Because when they get home...
Honestly, they get more attention...
Right. If they're being bad.
School, they have a better time in being there after school, a lot of them.
Right. Well, if there's enough of them, I'm sure they would.
That they almost would rather be there than go home.
Yeah.
And, you know, so what are you supposed to do? I mean, I see our teachers and principals struggling with it all the time. I hear them talking about it all the time.
Yeah,
I mean,
it's like...
You know, they're at a point... They even do Saturday school.
Yeah.
They don't care. There's just they just keep the same ones keep going.
Yeah.
So, you know.
Yeah, there's.
I don't know. You get limited. You start finding creative ways to try to do things. You know. I mean.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true.
I'm not totally against this in a way. You know, because I agree with Jerome over here. It's like, you know, it's.
It's not. You know, I'm not real big on people plastering their kids all over the Facebook and the internet in the first place, but.
Right. Well.
But it is what it is now, and
right.
You know I. I certainly, like anything else, can come to a degree where you went overboard.
Yeah, and, absolutely.
You know, the humiliation can turn into something else. But.
Well, humiliation, though, and this reminds me of when I had a buddy down in Texas one time, got a DUI. And instead of, and this was a while back, but instead of, you know, just sending him to jail or whatever, they actually made him walk around the block, around the courthouse, with a sign, a big sign.
Yeah, I've actually
saying, I was a dumbass, and I got caught driving drunk, you know, for a whole day. And you know what? he even told me, he said, that was probably the worst punishment of my life.
Yeah.
To have to look at everybody looking at me and honking their horns and telling me what a jackhole I was, you know?
Right.
I mean, humiliation can actually be a very, you know, well-utilized tool if done tastefully.
How is it a whole lot different than, say, the kid supposed to be spending the night somewhere, okay?
Okay. Right.
And they – okay, you got a group of, say, five guys or girls.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And – they're all saying they're spending the night at each other's houses.
Sure.
But they all are actually going to spend a night at some party.
Right. Right.
And all the parents get talking about it and find out, oh, no, they're not there. They're at the party, you know.
Right.
How much different is it to have that on Facebook in front of all their friends than for the parents to come storming into that house and grab them all and yank them out of the house in front of everybody?
Right.
I mean, it's the same principle.
Well,
and the humiliation punishments
if you showed
are
up
not
at a party,
new.
Yeah, I mean, I agree. If
they've
you
done it clear back and –
yeah,
right.
You know, medieval ages.
Yeah, I mean, if you showed up at the party, that would be way more humiliating to them than you making them put a sign on Facebook saying,
so
oh, hey, I got caught
it would
on
be
Facebook.
Me,
see, to me, I think it's probably worse to do it on Facebook just because you never know what's going to go viral, so to speak. You know, that could be.
Well, that's where I think we get into the where's the line drawn kind of thing. I mean,
that could be, you know, worldwide, whereas your parents come get you at a party is, you know,
well, sure,
whoever's there.
Yeah, I agree.
You have no way to contain it once you put it on the internet.
It's got
to
be tasteful, though. That's why you've got to make sure it's in a tasteful sense.
And there,
you're not just
some...
sitting there calling them a retard or, you know.
Yeah,
you know, you're not just going full out with it.
Right. There are some situations. This one that you put up probably isn't a very good
illustration
because – I mean, the girl apparently was having standing around holding liquor bottles and everything in those same places, so everybody already knew she was doing it.
Yeah.
You know, and it's not – I mean, it's not –
well, here's my thing.
It's not a good thing, but it's not a terrible thing. But there are some things that not everybody needs to know that kids do. You know what I mean? That,
well, and that's the thing,
and
though.
And that's kind of where the line gets drawn.
Right.
You're
going to
be throwing something up there that – you know, the kid made a mistake, and not everybody in the world really needs to know that they did that.
Right? All right, but not everybody.
Now you've gotten into a whole new ballgame.
But in the same regards, think about this. Not everybody needed to know that she was holding fucking liquor bottles either.
No.
You know,
once
she posted that shit, it's in the same sense.
She's the one that broke the...
Yeah, you know, so when he says, oh, it could go completely worldwide, well, that was, you know, she made that choice to begin with.
Yeah, that's
true. So as the parent's response... it's not anything bad or anything different than what she did to begin with, you know, than what the child did.
Yeah.
You know? Now, like I said, I'm not all about bashing your kids out there.
Right.
All right? I don't think you should bash your kids in your own home. You know, I don't think you should make them feel to that point where they're completely degraded.
Right, like a dog that's been beat too
much. Right. In this sense, I think if they were willing to make that choice and post that kind of bullshit out there, then you as a parent should almost respond in the same way to make them understand what could really happen. This is what could happen.
Right.
You know? And then she starts getting all these responses from people she don't even fucking know. And it's like, well, what the hell?
Right. You know? Right. Yeah. Say she was posting risque photos of herself on Facebook and stuff like that. Do you still use the Facebook against her?
I lock my goddamn daughter up for the rest of her life.
Well, I'm just saying, man. I mean,
no,
the drinking thing to me isn't all that big a deal. But if she was say posting risque photos or even, you know,
that's
putting a judgment on what you
consider bad. Let's change your question just a little bit.
Okay.
Because. You're asking, okay, she put the risque photos on Facebook.
Yeah.
And so the parents go put a response on Facebook.
Right.
Well, again, everybody that's going to see the response already saw the risque photos, so they already know what was going on.
Right.
Yeah.
So, you know, maybe I don't know that I'd have a huge problem with that.
Exactly.
But say she was sending risque photos and text to people.
Right. And
or
then,
passing just pictures around or something like that that wasn't as public, was more to a more secluded audience.
Yeah.
Then to go and throw it up on Facebook where,
Yeah,
70% more people are going to see it.
Yeah. Right.
Now you got an issue.
Yeah, now, and I agree. Like, if that picture you showed said...
Because the people that hadn't seen it yet don't even know about it.
Exactly. I mean, if the sign said, I got caught at a party, so now I have to hold this photo saying that, you know, I was at a party, that's a whole different situation.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? If you take something that was private and then make it public... Then yes.
And that is something that happens, too.
And it does. And that's what I'm saying. That does happen. And that's fucked up. Any of you motherfuckers out there doing that shit, and you know, screw that.
Right.
If something's happening in private, keep it in private.
Yeah.
You know? Now, if your freaking kid's being a freaking jackhole out in public, then
by all means,
make sure that the whole public knows that they were being a jackhole. You know? I mean... But I agree with, you know, Palsy over here. It's one of those things. Private's private. Public's public.
Yeah.
Your response should be accordingly.
And, you know, not even talking punishment-wise, you see it on an everyday basis. I do on my Facebook with people that were my classmates. And so,
yeah.
You know, they're throwing everything about their kids up there, and it's like, you know.
Yeah, everything.
Does everything have to be public? I mean.
Right.
You know.
Right.
That's a whole,
I understand, you know, you got something you're proud of them about, and you throw it up there and whatever.
But say Johnny's doing horrible in school, and then Johnny's mom, she posts that Johnny, he's just must be a real dumb dumb because he can't get an A+ in art or whatever.
No, that's where you cross the line.
Yeah,
that's where you cross the line. That's where it's like that kind of thing doesn't need to be shown to your whole 400 freaking friends that you have that you don't even, you know, you talk to half these freaking people.
And
they don't need to know all that shit.
And 700 of them are, you know, people you just play games with and don't even know and everything else.
But, yeah, I totally agree. You know, it's one of those things where there is a fine line as far as what should be public and what should... Now, like for me, you know, most of the people I have on my Facebook are actually people that I do talk to, you know? And so I don't mind posting stuff about my kids or things like that.
No.
But it's always good stuff, too. You know, I'm not going to, you know, if my kid's doing bad in school, I'm not going to sit there and post something about how my kid's doing bad in school. That's just screwed up.
Yeah, that's fine.
That's going to be left to, you know, me, their mother, maybe a few close personal friends, really close personal friends. And that's it, you know, and my family. I mean, that's just how it goes. You know, you're not going to throw that kind of thing out to everybody and their dog. I mean, that's just not how it is.
No, you shouldn't. You shouldn't. It's wrong.
And like I said, the punishment thing should be accordingly.
Right.
Okay? You know, if you catch a kid doing something in private, punish them in private.
Yeah.
If you catch them doing something stupid in public, by all means, let them know how stupid that was by punishing them publicly.
Right.
You know? This way they get the idea that, hey, what I did was absolutely retarded. Because... You know, like Palsy said, you have to make sure that they understand, you know, where it is.
Yeah.
You know,
and
like these kids that go to detention and shit, they think, oh, it's no big fucking deal. You know why? Because when they get home, they don't get punished.
Yeah, right.
They don't get detention at home.
No.
You know, so it's no big deal to them.
Right.
You know,
and like, I think having detention kind of like goes with a certain status in school, like. Maybe it's cool to get detention. You know
sometimes,
what I mean? You know what I mean? And especially
especially
those kids that that aren't the popular ones.
Yeah.
They want to act out in order to try to make themselves seem popular. Right, and they want to be popular.
Right.
You know what I mean? And they want to have lots of friends. And in order to they feel like in order to have those friends and to be popular that they need to get detention or act out in class or you know whatever it may be. You know, fucking school, man.
I think kids these days are just a bunch of idiots.
Well, and a lot of that's because the parents are a bunch of idiots.
Well, that's true.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
True. I mean,
it's been
we got a kid in our school who's one of them kids, right?
Yeah.
Every day. I mean, he hangs out in the school after school. Not supposed to. He's supposed to get out. He's in there hanging around, messing around, flipping around in the halls, and jacking around. But he's always having to stay after school. Anyway,
right?
Because he's always late, doesn't have his work done, and whatever. And, you know, I walk over to the convenience store at 12:30, 1 in the morning, you know.
And that's where he's at.
Grab a pack of smokes or something, and he's in there wandering around buying candy and crap while his mom's waiting out in the car.
To me,
and I'm going, what?
That is not the kid's fault.
No wonder he's late. Especially
early middle school and definitely the elementary school.
Yeah.
If you're late to first period, that's not the kid's fault.
Right.
That is
the way the school takes it too.
Yeah.
You know,
and that's good for them to take it that way. That's not the kid's fault.
I've heard our former principal.
Yeah.
And I imagine our current one has too, but I just have never heard it. But I directly heard him saying that to parents, you know.
Yeah. If a kid's late to the beginning of school.
You're telling them, you know, this kid's 9 years old, all right? Yeah.
Your children,
he didn't get to school by himself.
Right.
No,
your children are a product of you,
yeah.
All right? They learn from you. They understand how things are done from you.
Right.
If you don't take the initiative to teach them how to do things correctly, don't expect them to do them correctly, period.
Right.
You know? I mean, I have those issues with my children where it's one of those things where you have to explain to them, you know, like, look, what you're doing here is just not right, you know? And you've got to be able to make that distinction between right and wrong.
Yeah.
Now, if a parent doesn't feel that it's wrong, then obviously their kid's not going to think it's wrong. And that's just how it is.
Yeah.
So if you don't think that showing up to school on time is a big deal, your kid's not going to.
No.
You know?
Or
if
showing up to anything.
Yeah. I mean, and that's where it leads to.
Yeah.
It starts with the first hour
on time with my mom. Then
Why should I go to fourth hour, fifth hour? Why should I even show up for the rest of the day?
Right.
You know, I mean, and this is where the problem lies. You give them, especially with children, because they want you give them, you give them an inch, they take a mile because they're kids.
Right.
They think,
right.
Oh well, if that's how it is, then I'll just don't do anything. You know, and you're right. If parents don't fucking get their heads out of their asses,
yeah,
you know.
And be fucking responsible.
This is to all you parents.
Right.
Pull your head out of your asses.
Be responsible.
Be responsible parents.
Back to the punishment thing, you know.
Right or wrong.
I don't have a problem with it. I mean, you can't physically punish anymore. People are trying to find psychological ways to do it, and that's all you're left with. So.
Yeah, it's not completely wrong. Not completely wrong.
Depending
it's all you're left with.
Depending on the class and tastefulness of it all.
Yeah.
So, hey, if you're going to humiliate them, be classy about it, San Diego.
We got a hold of Kevin. Is that correct?
Yeah.
This is
I'm Frank in Chicago. I'll be Kevin here.
Frank in Chicago. Kevin here. All right. So I got. You know anything about Charlie Manson? Kevin.
Sure.
What do you know about him? Lay it on me.
He's. I don't know. Psycho. In prison.
A psycho, and he's in prison. Okay, got it. Okay, what if I told you he was getting married?
Well, yeah, something about that.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah. Is this cute little fucking 25-year-old?
The fuck?
25?
She is hot.
Yeah, she's hot.
Now, does she get conjugal visits?
No, actually, in the state of California, they didn't let... They did away with letting lifetimers get conjugal visits.
Well, then how the fuck is he getting married?
So then this really is like, I don't get this thing. Like, well, why get married to the dude?
There are people that wait to have sex until they get married.
Well, right, but she can't have sex.
But she said she can't.
Yeah.
So there will never be any consummating it, huh?
Well, they can't have conjugal visits, but I don't know. Maybe he'll get paroled.
I couldn't even imagine that.
Yeah, I see that one happening tomorrow. Yeah.
No, actually, this lady, her name is Star. And
yeah, there's a problem already.
Well, Charlie gave her that name. And so now she goes
What's her name?
Her name is Star.
No, she's a stripper, man. Come on.
Right?
No,
but she started becoming in contact with Charlie when she was 19 years old. And she actually runs several websites that is in devotion to defending Charlie Manson.
Well, that's a good way to spend free time.
Right? Jeez. I bet she's making money doing it, though.
How the hell are you going to make money for that?
Well, yeah, she's a stripper. I'm sure she makes good money.
There's a lot of wackos out there that are just, like, totally nuts about old Charlie.
Yeah.
I know, we're going to have a bunch of Charlie Manson wannabes after our asses.
Yeah.
Right.
He actually, he's in the California's Corcoran State Prison. And he's quite an old-timer now. He's 79 years old. He's not so spry. And that swastika's starting to fade. He actually is fucking really scary-looking. Of course, he's always been that way.
Right, I was going to say, he's always been a scary fucker.
He's just now getting scary-looking?
Yeah. Well, he's even worse now.
It's the old age that's doing it, huh?
No, he's worse now.
I don't think he looks nearly as scary right there.
You don't think
so?
You'd think
he would get less scary-looking the older he gets.
Exactly, exactly, Kevin.
Motherfucker.
He does not look nearly as scary as he used to.
Yeah?
No. Yeah. And especially when he's sitting next to that hot-ass broad. I mean, what the fuck is this girl doing?
You know what's funny?
Looks like they're getting
ready to
go play
tennis. By now he'd have, you know, like the big long white beard. You know, he'd look like Satan Claus or something.
No.
He's trimmed up.
Yeah. He looks.
He kind of looks halfway normal.
They look like they're getting ready to go out on the boat or go play tennis or something.
Yeah. If you didn't know any better, you'd say that.
I just don't get that. That girl is fucking banging.
She is pretty cute. You know what's funny is there's like a theory that she's actually the daughter of Sexy Sadie.
And Sexy
Sadie was one of the ladies that was incarcerated for her role in the Tate LaBianca killings.
You mean stabbing a bunch of people?
And there's like a theory. I don't know if it's true or not. Doesn't say. She of course denies it, but she says that it's possible for her to be Charlie's daughter.
Oh my God. I'm sticking with Kevin's.
Is that legal in the state of California?
I don't know. I don't know,
but I'm sticking with Kevin's theory where she's a stripper with some serious daddy issues. Serious daddy issues. Right? Serious stepdad.
Especially if her dad's fucking Charlie Manson.
Right?
Oh, wow. That's a whole new twist to the plot.
That's what I'm saying, dude. I was just reading about this today.
No.
And I was like, holy shit. This fucking thing just got deep. But,
dude, yeah.
You know. Hey, speaking
balls
of...
Balls deep.
Speaking of which, is it cool? Okay, let me lay this one on you. Okay, you have an illegitimate daughter at a young age.
Wait, how do you know?
Yeah, no, I'm just...
hypothetically.
Hypothetically speaking.
We don't talk about that shit.
Say you have an illegitimate daughter... And you didn't know, you had no clue, okay?
Yep.
You turn into, like, Hugh Hefner towards the end of your life. You're, like, 78, 90 years old, whatever.
Shit, I'm Hugh Hefner now.
And nowadays, these girls, young girls, like to date those older guys and get married to them.
pet.
Say, come to find out through blood tests or whatever, that this is your daughter that you've been banging.
Why are you gonna lay that on me, man?
Right? What the fuck is that, dude?
No, I'm just hypothetically speaking, because this is basically.
All right, that's when you
I'm putting yourself into Charlie's shoes here.
I imagine it would be something like that Ace Ventura movie, you know, when he finds out
that
he's making out with the dude.
Yeah. it's that bad or worse?
Oh yeah.
No, man.
Well, no, that'd be worse.
Yeah.
That'd be worse.
I don't know. Throw the fucking goddamn DNA test out the goddamn window and say fuck it.
And say
you never saw that shit.
Seriously? You'd be like, ain't nobody gonna need this anymore.
Burn it.
Into the trash.
One of the things that did not happen.
Is that right or wrong, Kevin? Or Frank, whatever.
Oh, that's wrong. That's wrong on more than one level, man. That's just wrong, wrong, wrong.
Yeah. Oh, El Pawsey, what do you think?
Yeah.
Oh, wait. How hot is it? How hot is your
illegitimate? Oh,
she's banging hot.
She's A+, dude.
Yeah, banging hot.
She's a dime. She's a dime.
Wait, did he say cousin?
No, that's wrong, man. It's wrong, wrong, wrong.
Whatever,
man.
Dude. You burn the test. Don't even.
Do you or do you not burn the test?
Burn the test.
Do
you burn or do you not test. Burn the test? Do you burn the test?
What?
Do you burn the test?
Do I burn the test?
Yeah.
No. You don't take the test because you don't want to find out.
Exactly. See, there's a smart fella.
That boy's not even taking the
right.
test.
Right. We ain't even.
Yeah, like once there becomes the issue, you're just like, ah, you're talking. I ain't answering myself.
See, that's what I don't get. Why the fuck are you goddamn DNA testing the chick you're banging?
Yeah, I mean, I don't know.
You're
maybe.
Banging her. What the fuck do you want to know? Why the hell would you want to know if she's related to you? Bang the shit out of her and be done with it.
Well, I think old Greg's actually banged a cousin of his and just recently found out. Is that correct?
No.
No?
No, I knew she was my cousin.
Your cousin's not your daughter either.
Right? Cousins are not daughters, okay?
That's
not an illegitimate cousin.
I was actually reading through some laws today, and in one of the states, it is Arkansas, but in one of those states, once you turn 55, it is legal. That means you can do it. Legal that you can marry your cousin.
You're talking like first cousin, right?
Yeah, first cousin.
Okay.
Like,
but only.
Why does it matter how old you are?
I don't know, but no.
Because apparently at 55 they don't give a.
Not so wrong when you're 55.
No, it's
apparently
only.
They don't give a fuck at 55.
At that point, they just decided if they figured it out by now. Then go ahead.
They figure you're old enough now. If you can still get it up, then fuck it. Fuck whatever.
No, seriously. No, but it's only legal if you can't have kids together.
Oh, God.
So say one of you is still able to get pregnant or to be the pregnant.
That's got to be Arkansas.
The pregnator.
That's just weird.
Then it's illegal.
Yeah, that's just weird.
No,
you know, there's fucking clause in these weird laws, you know that.
I don't understand it, man.
I don't either.
Like, that's what makes it wrong, the fact that, you know, you can have a child.
Yeah,
so,
that's basically good
that you're having sex with your cousin. That's what makes it wrong.
Right.
Whether you have a kid or not.
Yeah.
You can eat apple pie you can have ice cream, but you can't have the ice cream on your apple pie.
What's the rules on your sister?
What's
I know
the rules
you have to marry your sister.
I'm not touching my sister.
Is it like 75 to marry your sister? If your mom's still alive and you're 85, go ahead and marry her.
Right. Yeah,
if your mom's still alive, you can't do it, man.
Right.
As long as your parents are still alive, you cannot marry your sister. That's the way it works.
That's the rules.
Jesus.
That's the rules.
Man, that is just stupid. Stupid.
So what do you got going on, man? You driving?
Yeah, I'm riding. I'm not driving.
Oh, you're not. Are you a lot lizard or a truck driver?
Well, I'm neither.
Oh. You're not in a semi.
I'm simply a passenger, man.
You're not in a semi truck right now?
Well, I don't kiss and tell.
Wait, wait. Oh. Is he masturbating?
Are you touching it?
Well,
no,
I'm always touching it.
Okay, time out. Have you touched your genitalia in a way that would be deemed inappropriate in public today?
Oh, today?
Yeah.
Like within the last hour? Or?
No.
I was just at the gas station.
Just today.
I was just at the gas station, man. Oh. So.
Hey, every time I reach in my pocket, I'm touching myself in a weird way, all right?
You just figured out a way around this whole public fucking thing, huh?
Oh, shit.
Right, yeah. I mean, it doesn't matter if it's a public or not.
You telling me you never heard of pocket pool? Seriously?
No, I've shot a few games myself.
Well, Kevin just prefers to do it on a daily basis.
Yeah.
You put the twig on one side and the berry on the others, man. Put both hands in your pocket, you're good to go.
Yeah. This is
you did not.
This is a fucking.
Oh, it's so itchy.
This got a bad itch, man. Bad itch.
So.
Oh shit.
You been doing any risque things lately?
Me? Been doing any risque things?
Yeah. That you're willing to talk about?
Well, not really. I don't want to, you know, like I said, I don't kiss his tail.
Yeah? Nobody turned you into a puppet lately?
Well, I might have turned somebody else into a puppet.
The puppeteer. We said fuck the bus driver. We're right. Going straight to puppeteer.
Your name isn't Frank or Kevin or anything like that anymore. It's now the puppeteer.
That's right.
Yes.
Right. He's the puppeteer.
So, puppeteer.
I thought that's what your name was.
Yeah, I like to go by the puppeteer, but...
Dustin just doesn't like to get
it's
that
too yucky.
Far deep.
It's too yucky.
Yeah, he prefers the bus driver.
No, I don't... Like, honestly, man, anything that has to do with butthole, I don't want anything about it. Honestly.
Oh, bullshit. You're telling me if some hot-ass chick sat there and said, fuck me in the ass, you wouldn't do it.
It depends on how hot, man.
Oh, my God.
If you're talking dime, I probably would.
That's just stupid.
If you're talking dime, I probably would.
Really? Yeah. You wouldn't even be great that shit?
Oh, they'd have to be 8+.
Oh.
8+, man.
A B.
No.
A B couldn't look at you and very sexily say it. Stick it in there. And you wouldn't do it.
I guess it depends on the heat of the moment, man.
That
stuff grosses me out.
What if you just kind of snuck it in there and you didn't know? Like, what if it's in the dark and then, you know, it kind of falls out, she grabs it, just sticks it in a hole? What if you don't know?
Okay, I've had anal sex before.
Anal sex before?
And you know.
Wait a second. Wait a second.
Wait.
Okay, go ahead.
Were you the pitcher or the catcher?
That's what I was just getting ready to ask.
I'm the bull moose, man. I'm not the...
Yeah, I mean, if I was a catcher, I wouldn't like anal sex either, man.
Yeah, I don't blame you.
I've never, like...
I'm the bull moose.
I have given some anal sex to
That's where I was going with it, man. I'm just not into butthole stuff, man.
Oh, shit.
Are you,
hey man, it happens.
You are into butthole stuff, Greg?
Dude, if the bitch turns around and says, stick it in my ass, I'm going to stick it in her ass. Bitch turned around and says, stick it in my ass and stick it in my mouth, I'm going to stick it in her ass, I'm going to stick it in her mouth. I'm going to stick it wherever the bitch tells me to stick it.
What if she whips out the dildo on you?
Whoa, now, wait a second. Am I using it on her?
No. You got turned into the twink.
So. No. I did not say I like to get fucked in the ass.
You
I don't
went
mind
from
fucking someone in the ass.
Now, all right. What if she was only going to give you a blowjob if she could stick her pinky finger up your ass? And it's a small pinky.
Just
finger.
The pinky.
She's got tiny little hands.
Just the pinky.
Just
the pinky. Is she gonna?
I'd probably do it.
I was gonna say, is she gonna? Is she gonna rim job it as well? Is she gonna kind of? I mean, as long as she plays with it a little bit.
I tell you what, man.
My public answer is no.
There is no public here, Palsy. No.
Are you into anal, Palsy?
No, I'm not doing it.
You're not doing it?
What?
Are you into anal?
Which end? Because I don't want to answer this at all.
Okay.
All right. You're all not right. Getting it. You're getting
it. Okay. You're the giver, not the taker.
You like to pitch it or what?
Make sure that wasn't a trick question.
No.
Don't worry. We'll be straight with you.
No.
I'm not into it really. Either, dude. I don't blame you. That's not my thing.
Hey, I'll be honest with you. 100%, like, not totally into it. I mean, I figure if I'm going to fuck somebody in the ass, I might as well be gay. However, if the girl turns around and looks at you and says, stick it in my ass, you got to stick it in her ass, man.
Yeah. Look, bygones be bygones.
Exactly. Huh? You just, you can't deny the woman's needs, man.
Hey, Frank. Puppeteer. Yo.
What? Hey, puppeteer.
What are you doing?
I don't know, you dumbass.
What are you doing over there?
He's
well, I had my hand in my pocket.
He's got his hand in his pocket. We're talking about anal sex. He's got his hand in his pockets, man.
Hey.
Yeah.
I'm equal opportunity when it comes to holes, man.
Yeah, there you go.
Whatever it falls in, it falls in, huh?
If it's warm and I can stick my dick in it, I'm probably good.
even the old ear canal, huh?
Hey, if there's chance.
Earwax that shit.
Hey, hell,
up, man.
I'll give it hell, man. It doesn't have to fit. I'll just give it. I'll give it a go.
Just try like hell, like a fucking dog humping a leg.
Hey, sometimes that's more fun than actually fucking something, man.
Yeah, it's the challenge.
Right.
Huh?
You're probably right.
It's like, you know, when you got a really fat girl and you think you're fucking her, but you're actually, you know, ramming her in the belly button. Hey,
nice.
This is good.
Nice.
This is the best sex I've ever had.
Right?
Holy shit.
That's what she looks at you and says, you want to stick it in or what?
Right?
Yeah.
No, I
she asked me if I was going to stick it in. I said, I'm done already.
I'm already done.
I tell you what, man. Bigger girls usually give the best blowjobs.
Well, yeah, that's usually all they can do.
They do, man.
Well, no, that's not necessarily true, man. I don't know how many big girls you've been with, but
that's actually
true. I don't know how many either.
How many big girls have been with?
We're not counting.
We're
tonight.
Not counting tonight.
No. Let's not.
We ain't
let's
going
not,
into that.
Let's not go there. Let's not start counting.
Right. No.
Hey, I will agree with old Frank over here. It's a hit and miss with some of them.
Yeah. I guess I've just had good luck.
Never been with a big girl?
No.
Really?
It usually makes me pretty upset, too, when they're not really good at it, because it's like, hey.
Everybody's got to have it.
Right?
No, I haven't had a big girl moment.
No?
Oh. Okay, this weekend, old fucking Palsy's going whaling.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dude.
Gotta get this guy a big girl.
We need to take him out and
all right, go chubby chasing.
Yeah, we need to have a chubby chasing contest.
Yeah.
I'm scared of girls that look like they can break me in half.
No.
I'd be more scared of them suffocating you when they sit on your face.
Yeah. I watched an episode of CSI where that fucking happened.
What?
Yeah.
For the what?
A CSI?
Yeah, CSI Las happened? Vegas, dude.
What
no
missed.
Shit.
Yeah. The fucking... there's a bigger girl and a smaller guy, and she was doing the old sitting on the face thing.
Oh, yeah. I saw
and
that one.
Ended up suffocating him, and he died.
I can't
Holy
bear
shit.
That grandma was watching that one.
Oh, you watched that one with grandma?
She watched it.
She probably didn't know she was sitting on his face.
She's like, that's not how we used to do it.
Not how it's done.
Why is she sitting on his face?
Oh, she thinks she's Pinocchio. Oh, shit.
Yep.
Did she have a tumor or something?
That's good shit. Good shit.
So, anyways, Frank, I'd like to thank you for calling in.
Yes, sir.
And have a safe trip. Have a thankful Thanksgiving. And
keep your hands out your pockets.
Yeah, well, as much as you can.
As much as you can.
You know that stuff will make you go blind, right?
Only if you shoot it in
what?
Your eye.
It makes you go deaf, too, man.
Yeah, apparently it does. So, anyways, I'd like to tell everybody that Hastings Music Store is now, or whatever the fuck they're called now, is Hastings and MTV are kind of like the same thing.
What?
You know how MTV used to play music videos?
Yeah.
Hastings used to sell just music.
Yeah.
That was a good one. I like that.
So anyways, but they are buying used vinyl now. Yeah. So you got any used vinyl, take it up to Hastings. They'll give you a couple dimes for it.
I got some used rubber. Anybody want those?
No.
Old Greg.
You're supposed to flush those down the toilet, man.
What? You don't flush those down the toilet, man. That'll kill a duck
not
or something.
Not in my school.
Want it?
That's what I do.
Doesn't that, like, kill geese or something like that?
It's like tampons. You don't flush them down the toilet, man.
Yeah.
Makes janitors and maintenance men
What are you supposed to cut the
fucking... nobody want to pull a goddamn used condom out of the toilet, okay?
What are you supposed
to fucking... You don't want to know the stuff I found down in there, all right?
What are you supposed to fucking cut the tip off and throw it in the trash?
Well, yeah, man. You don't kill little baby ducks because you goddamn can't cut that thing in half or something.
Oh, Jesus. Now I've heard everything. All right. Well, thanks again, Frank. We're going to wrap it up.
All right.
With all this, Frank calling in. Old Greg.
All right.
Peace out, man.
Peace out, buddy.
Peace out, Frank.
Palsy.
Later, everybody.
This has been another vinyl experience. Oh.